Final part of this series is concerned with the Phillips curve. The short-run Phillips curve is the relationship between unemployment and inflation when the expected inflation rate and the natural unemployment rate are both held constant. It suggests that in the short run, there is a trade-off between inflation and unemployment. The cost of maintaining low unemployment is high inflation, and the cost of maintaining low inflation is high unemployment. This is important to consider when authorities make decisions about how to deal with inflation or unemployment, as they must consider the other as well. The long-run Phillips curve is the relationship between inflation and unemployment when the actual inflation rate is equal to the expected inflation rate. It is vertical at the natural unemployment rate because in the long run, any expected inflation rate is possible. The curve being vertical implies that there is no relationship at all between the inflation rate and unemployment rate. A change in the expected inflation rate will shift the short-run Phillips curve and only the short-run Phillips curve. The intersection of the long-run and short-run Phillips curves indicates the expected rate of inflation. If the expected inflation rate increases, the short-run Phillips curve shifts upward, and if it decreases, then the short-run Phillips curve shifts downward. A change in the natural unemployment rate will shift both the long-run and short-run Phillips curves. An increase in the natural unemployment rate will shift both curves outward, and a decrease in the natural unemployment rate will shift both curves to the left. In both cases, the expected inflation rate does not change, and thus there is no vertical movement of the short-run Phillips curve. The movement is only horizontal. That was the series on business cycle theory.